And for the value for rigidity index and reduced rigidity index, I sub R and I sub RR, make use of this equation where our M is 100 to 200 for loose soil, 200 to 500 for medium dense soil, and 500 to 1000 for dense soil. So we have to identify the value for these parameters. And for the basis of the cone penetration test, he gave this correlation for using the cone penetration test. You have here the correlations for the rigidity index. Now we have here a table showing to us the bearing capacity factors and so sigma asterisk. We just need the value for rigidity index I sub RR, this one, and the angle of friction so that we can have the value for our bearing capacity factor and sub sigma asterisk. This one is at the table showing to us the variations of the value, the variations of N sub C asterisk. We need also the value for our reduced rigidity index. So for this one, for our clay, according to him, when clay for P is equal to zero, our ultimate point bearing capacity of the pile is equal to this equation. Our C sub U is the undrained cohesion. And according to the expansion of cavity theory of Vesic, N sub C asterisk is equal to this equation. When saturated clay, when it is a saturated clay with no volume change, our reduced rigidity index is equal to rigidity index. And for phi is equal to zero, this is the value for our rigidity index. So we have here the value for our approximation for the value for the rigidity index. According to Coyle's and Castillo's method for estimating Q sub P in sand, this is his theory, or this is the equations he presented, where Q sub P for the ultimate point bearing capacity of a pile is equal to the effective vertical stress at the pile tip multiplied to N sub Q asterisk times our A sub P. So this one is a variation of N sub Q asterisk with the ratio of L all over D based on Coyle and Castillo. So we need to have the value for the angle of friction as well as the ratio between embedment ratio so that we can have our bearing capacity factor N sub Q asterisk. So we have here a sample problem. Consider a 20 meter long concrete pile with a cross section of 0.407 meters and 0.407 meters fully embedded in sand. For the sand, given a unit weight gamma, which is 18 kilonewton per cubic meter, soil friction angle is 35 degrees. Estimate the ultimate point Q sub P, which the following. Now you're going to use Mayer equation, basic method, the method of Coyle and Castillo. So based on the result of parts A, B, and C, adopt a value for Q sub P. So for the first one, using the Mayer method, you're going to have your Q sub P, this equation, it should be less than or equal to this expression. So we need the value for N sub Q asterisk. So based on table presented a while ago in table 9.5, for our angle of friction, which is 35 degrees, we have the value for our N sub Q asterisk. Also for our Q prime, which is gamma times L, this is equal to 360 kilonewton per meter squared. So therefore, we can have now the value for our using the Mayer method. So our point bearing capacity is equal to approximately 8,528 kilonewton. Then for this one, we have to compare this value to this equation. So substituting the given parameters, so we have here approximately 829 kilonewtons. So therefore, based on this equation, this should be less than or equal. Since this is greater than to this expression, so we use the value of this expression or this equation, which is 829 kilonewton. This is now our Q sub P. Now, based on basic equation, point bearing capacity is given by A sub P, sigma sub O, and sub sigma asterisk. So we have to get the value for sigma sub O as sigma sub O prime. So this is given by this equation. You simply have to substitute the given values. So it gives us 222.34 kilonewton per meter squared. So we have to assume, we have a while ago, we were presented by this equation and we have given values for M, for loose soil, for medium soil. So for this one, this is a medium sand. So the value ranges from 200, I think, to 500. So we assume here that M is approximately 250. So if we try to substitute to this equation, we can solve for our the modulus of elasticity. We're given with atmospheric pressure, which is 100. So our E sub S is 25,000 kilonewton per meter squared. So we have to solve also for mu sub S using this equation and delta using this equation. That gives us 0.25 and 0.009. So we can solve now for our rigidity index, I sub R, which is equal to this equation, and it gives us 39.67. Our reduced rigidity index equal to this equation, it gives us 29.23. So therefore, having the value for our reduced rigidity index and our angle of friction using our table 9.7 presented a while ago, the value for N of sigma asterisk is approximately 47. So therefore, we can have now the value for our Q sub P using the basic equation and gives us 1,731 kilonewton. And for the last one, for the last method by Coyle and Castillo, presented this equation. So we need the value for our bed embedment ratio, which is 49.1. So we have P, which is 35 degrees. So therefore, based on figure 9.15, our S sub Q asterisk is 34. So therefore, our point bearing capacity Q sub P is equal to 2,028 kilonewton. Based on the given values, the value for Coyle and Castillo is too large. So therefore, we try to get the average of the result from Mayer of method value and the basic value. So therefore, the value for that is 821 plus 1,731 all over 2. The average is 1,280 kilonewtons. So our point bearing capacity is 1,280 kilonewtons. Now we move on to correlations for calculating Q sub P with our standard penetration test and the cone penetration test result in granular soil. So on the basis of observation, according to Mayeroff, he suggested that the ultimate point resistance Q sub P, the small Q sub P, in a homogeneous granular soil may be obtained from this, from standard penetration number. You can have your ultimate point resistance Q sub P for homogeneous granular soil equal to this equation. So this left member should be less than or equal to this expression. This is using a standard penetration number values. So of course our N sub 60, those are the average value of the standard penetration number near the pile point, and P sub A is our atmospheric pressure. According to Broad, he suggested that the correlation of the ultimate point resistance in granular soil with the standard penetration resistance value is equal to this equation, wherein Mayeroff also suggested that Q sub P would be equal to our cone penetration resistance, Q sub C. So we have here a sample problem. Consider a concrete pile that is 0.305 meters by 0.305 meters in cross section in sand. The pile is 12 meters long. The following are the variations of N60 with depth. So we are given here with the value of the standard penetration numbers. We have our depth below the ground surface with corresponding N sub 60 value. We have to estimate our point bearing capacity Q sub P. So for our first, for our solution, we're going to get the value for Q sub p. So therefore, we have to, since that is a standard penetration, number values, so basically we have to get the average. So the average of the N6T values would be 10 dB above and about 5 dB below the pile tip. So if you're going to have, this is our D, which is 0.305 times 10, that is approximately 3. And since this is 3, it's stated that the average should be 10 dB above. So the pile tip is 12 meters below the ground surface. So actually, our 10 dB above would be 12 minus 10 dB, that is 9. So if you're going to have 9, so this is our depthness, which is 9. So the N6T is 18. So we're going to have here, you're going to start 18. Then 5 dB below the pile tip, 5 times 0.305 is approximately 1.5. So this is 5 dB below the pile tip. So that is below the pile tip, which is 1.5. So plus 12, that is 13.5. So basically from this, this is the depth, which is 13.5. It has a N60 of 20. So therefore, our average N60 would be in between 9 and 13.5. So that will be 18 plus 11 plus 17 plus 20 divided by 4. So it gives us 16.5, or approximately 17. Now, since we have now the value for N sub 60, you can have now the value for Q sub P, which is equivalent to this equation. And if you try to substitute, this expression is equal to 2488.8 kilonewton, and this one is equal to 633 kilonewton. So therefore, since this is greater compared to this, we're going to make use the value of this equation. Our Q sub P, capital Q sub P, is 633 kilonewton. So for this one, the second part is, you're going to have, you're going to make use of this equation. So basically for this, if you try to simply substitute the given values that we have computed, our Q sub P is 508.2 kilonewton. Now we move on to frictional resistance, or the Q sub S in sand. So the frictional resistance, our Q sub S approx, is equal actually to the summation of P multiplied to delta L times F. Of course, this F is a unit frictional resistance, which is hard to estimate. So in making an estimation of our frictional resistance, several important factors must be kept in mind. So we have here the different important factors that you have to consider in the estimation for our unit frictional resistance. So the nature of the pile is insulation. You have to consider that one. It should have observed that the nature of the variation of F in the field is approximately as shown in this figure. So this is a unit resistance, a unit frictional resistance for piles in sand. So the unit skin friction shown in the figure increases with depth more or less linearly to a depth of L prime and remains constant thereafter. So this is an illustration. So the unit frictional resistance increases with respect to depth and a certain period of time, it remains constant. It is L prime here is approximately equal to 15 dB. At similar depth, the unit skin friction in loose sand is higher for a high displacement pile compared with a low displacement pile. At similar depth, bored or jetted piles will have a lower unit skin friction compared with the driven pile. So if you try to take into account the preceding factors, we can have an approximate relationship of F that for Z when equal to 0 to L prime, our unit frictional resistance is equal to K times sigma sub O prime times tangent small delta prime. And for Z equal to L prime to L, you have this equation. F is equal to F sub Z of L, which is equal to L prime. And we have to take note that capital K is the effective earth pressure coefficient, sigma sub O prime is the effective vertical stress at the depth under consideration, and small delta prime is the soil pile friction angle.